Hey guys, this is Joy. I was just going to offer you guys a yoga class today. It's just going to be a short, fun class to get your body moving and wake up for the day. I also wanted this class to kind of be about finding your authentic self and being able to feel comfortable sharing that. That's something that I'm working on, is not worrying so much about if others like or dislike me, but just being myself and hoping that you guys can find some of that within this practice today. I also wanted to mention that if you want to donate, please feel free, if you're on Facebook, to send me any donations through Facebook Messenger Pay, because we are collecting donations for Small Business Saturday, because my husband and I are opening up our own small business. He's going to be doing lots of art and art classes. I'll be teaching yoga, dance, Pilates, and having our dance company perform and rehearse there and doing some performances for art ops. We want to invite other groups and just do lots of fun stuff for the community. So anyways, guys, feel free to donate. We always appreciate that. But if not, feel free to also just enjoy this class as a gift to you from us. And I hope you enjoy, and we will get started. So anyways, guys, too, while I'm getting this set up, if you ever want to come to class in person, feel free to message me if you don't know the location. But we're just right now, we're in 1101 Portage Street in the community room on the third floor, but we will be moving to the main level, 1103, in January, and then we'll have an actual studio rather than a temporary space. So that will be exciting. I hope you guys can come join us for classes now or later or anytime. So anyways, let's get moving. So we're actually gonna start sitting today. You can choose a cross leg position or a butterfly position. Let's take a few shoulder rolls back. And then let's go ahead and just take one hand on our belly, one hand on our heart. Take a deep breath in. Exhale. And just however you're feeling in this moment, take note of that. And find anything that maybe you're holding on to that you wish you could express, but maybe you feel held back from doing. And acknowledge if that's something that you want to either let go of or that you want to find the confidence to share. And just maybe set your intention today on allowing yourself to do what you need to kind of release or accept those things that maybe we're holding on to. So we're going to take one more deep breath in through the belly. Breathe into the ribs and chest, breathe into the lungs. And then as you exhale, let go of anything that you want to release from yourself today, and invite in confidence and self-love to be able to express what you need to be your authentic self. And then we're going to take a big breath in, sweep those arms up, bring the palms in front of the heart, and then we're just going to take a reach forward with those arms. Stretch out, lengthening from your lower back all the way through the top of the head. Breathe in. And let's exhale, just start to walk our hands over to the side here. So you can just mirror me, whether this is your left or right. Just reaching over to the side. And then let's reach a little further. Take this all the way into a big side reach. Gaze up under that arm. Pulling your body back up. Let's go ahead. Reach and tip. One, two, three times here. And then circle all the way through. Coming back to that first side reach twist. And lift the chest, breathe in. Exhale, let your chest fall over that knee. And then walk back through center. Breathe in. Exhale, let's walk our hands over to that other side now. So opposite side from where we just were. Breathing in. Exhaling, taking one more breath in. Very good. As we exhale, going all the way to the side, reaching long with that arm, breathe in. Exhale, gaze up, and then let's pull ourselves up, reaching over. One, and two, and three times, and then circling all the way through, finding that twist, lift through the chest. Very good job. From here, coming back center, taking one arm up, bend through that elbow, take your opposite hand, draw that hand down your back. So if you want to see what that might look like here, you can start here and maybe take your opposite arm under if you wish. Or if you prefer, feel free to take this to the other side at any point in time, and just holding the elbow if you wish, or taking the opposite hand under, just opening those shoulders a little bit more. Once you're ready, releasing those arms, shoulders roll back a few times. Shoulders still rolling forward now, one and two times, and then we're gonna bring our knees together. I'm gonna turn on my mat here now. Knees are together, we're gonna push our knees one side, and then other side. And just kind of add that little press. Good. And then pausing center, pointing through the toes. We're going to open the knees, press the heart and chest forward, round the spine, close the knees. And open, arch the back, lift the chest best that you can. Don't worry if your back is a little stiffer, maybe it won't be as extreme here, but just that little lift through the chest. And close, good. Then when you're ready, slide your hips back, flex those feet, lift your arms, circle your wrists, two, three, and on four, reverse. One, two, three, reach long. Think about reaching by hinging from your hip point rather than rounding from your upper back. So I'm trying to keep my chest open, and let's reach, 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 reach as far out as you can, maybe reaching past those feet. If you can't reach your toes yet, that's okay. Maybe you're holding behind your ankles, calves, or knees. Wherever you're at, pull that chest forward without rounding through that upper back. So I'm gonna keep everything as long as you can. Breathe in. Exhale, slowly roll up. Now from here, we're gonna go ahead, take a side stretch, seated. So one elbow reaches down towards the floor, opposite arm reaches side. Come up, other way, side. Good, breathe in. Exhale, let's turn. So I'm gonna start to walk my hands back towards my right hip, and we're gonna place our hands both down, one in front of the other, so right hand in front of left. Lift the hip, press down, sweep this arm out. This time we're gonna circle it all the way up. Side plank. Feel free to stack those feet if you like. Good, breathe in. So we're gonna come all the way down. We're gonna try that on the other side. So I'm gonna walk my hands back towards my left hip. Left hand in front of right. I'm gonna push the hips up from here. So our hands are staggered. Now lower that hip down this time. I'm gonna take my right arm up, all the way around, lift those hips, breathe in. Exhale, coming all the way back down. Let's come a little faster through this flow this time, just going up from one side. So we usually would do something like this, perhaps, from a plank. But here we're kind of facing our hips down towards the floor, going from the back side, trying to build a little more back strength. If you need a modification, you can slide one knee in and open up this way. So we're gonna flow a little bit here. Feel free to kind of pull the knees in as I'm showing. This is your modification. So always make sure whatever you're doing works for your body. Knee can come in. I'm gonna show now that more advanced variation for those of you that wanna keep those legs straight. Beautiful, let's do one more. Awesome job. This time, guys, we're gonna turn all the way into our plank, okay? Make your way around however you need to. If a plank is tough, feel free to do half plank. Hold 10, 9, breathe 8. 7, I like to rock on the toes, that's optional if you wish. 5, 4, 3, 2, on 1, lower chaturanga, breathe in. Exhale, begin to curl your heart open, maybe half lift, maybe all the way up. Let's do maybe 3 or so more lifts. So breathing in as we lower, exhaling, lift up. Breathing in as we lower, exhale as we lift up. Two more times, lower down, inhale. Exhale, lift up. Last one, inhale. Exhale, lift and hold. Tip that head back. Those of you that would like to bend the toes towards the head. Good, round up through the spine, hips to heels, child's pose. Take a moment here. Let's walk our hands to the left. Breathe in. Exhale. Okay, walking our hands the other way. Just find that beautiful stretch. Very good, let's come back center. Reach your hands towards the front of your mat. Take that puppy pose, heart melts down. Chest melts towards the floor, breathe in. Exhale, if you want a little bit more, maybe bend those elbows, palms towards the forehead. Once you're ready, slide up to your hands and knees, arch your back, bring those knees right under the hips, really, really round, and then release, head and tailbone up. And again, arch and round. Release, one more time. Arch and round, take your hands into it if you like. I like to add some expression with the hands, they do so much for us. Let's circle our head, one, two times rebirth. Feel free to be as expressive as you need to here. Let your spine come with you. Let your head and tailbone off, round circle, left to right, or right to left. We're gonna reverse, so once we're ready, now reverse, and I'm gonna switch right to left, circle up through that spine. Two, and three. Let's take a tuck through the toes, downward dog, sending the hips back. Head falls between those arms. Let's go ahead and slide back out to plank. Lower chaturanga, cobra, upward dog, breathe in. Exhale, downward dog. Take your right leg nice and high. Sweep it up and back. Now make sure your hands are far enough forward that you can shift to plank. You're going to take your right knee over towards your left elbow. Center, right elbow. Send it back. And again. Left elbow, center, right, and back. Just two more like this. We're kind of taking our time. Cross, center, side, and back. One more time. You can do this from your left knee if you need a modification. Good, and send it back, hold. Couple options, bend that knee, go into your scorpion, or flip into your wild thing if you wish. Breathe it in. Exhale, right hand down, right leg back up. Let's take that right leg up to a lunge. Back heel is gonna stay a lifted high lunge position. Breathe in. Let's see if we can exhale. Left elbow outside of right knee. Maybe take this twist. Maybe open. Maybe wrap. Inhale. Exhale. Take one more breath in. Good. As we exhale, unwind. Arms back up. Hands back down. Take your plank again. Lower chaturanga. Cobra or upward dog. Back through downward dog. Left leg sweeps nice and high. Breathe and hold. Maybe stay here, maybe bend that knee, maybe look under that arm if you wish. Maybe even flip that downward dog into sometimes called flip dog or sometimes called wild thing. Just breathe however you feel today. Okay, leg comes back up, inhale. Shift through plank, left knee goes right elbow, center, left. Send it back and cross the right elbow, center, left. Send it back a couple more times here. Right, center, left. Send it back one more time. We have right, center, left. Send the leg back, breathe in. Exhale, lunge that foot up. Sweep the arms nice and high. Breathe in. Exhale, back heel is still lifted. Palms in front of the heart, twist if you can. Right elbow outside, left knee. Maybe open those arms, maybe wrap the pulse. These are challenging to hold, so if you're feeling tired, no worries. You're almost there. Just hang in there if you can, or if you need to come out, that's okay too. One more breath in. Exhale, hands around front foot, plank. Lower chaturanga. Cobra or upward dog. Slowly lower your chest, lift your legs. Reach those arms back, locust pulse. Squeeze your heels all the way together. Now see how you're feeling. If this is enough, stay here. If you want more, bend your knees, reach your hands for your feet or ankles. Maybe even rock a little bit in that ball pose. Maybe even pull the legs back. Whatever feels good, okay? If you want to bring hands inside, you can pull a little higher. Just find that openness through the chest, through the heart. Once you're ready, let's melt that chest down. Let your head turn to one side. Kind of maybe shake your hips out, find a space where you feel relaxed for a moment. Rest your body. Deep breath in and out. Hands slide under the shoulders. Core is engaged, belly button pulls away from the floor. You're gonna push with your hands. Round and stretch back. Come up through a cat stretch. Right arm high. Right arm slides under left. Find a twist. Breathe in. Exhale, come back up. Left arm high. Left arm under right. Thread that shoulder all the way down. Maybe even let that right arm come overhead. Good. And coming back around. Back through downward dog. Tread through those feet. Option here to either jump to a little squat position or to jump through to seated. So I'll show you first. You can either jump to a squat, then take a seat, come into both, okay? Option two, you're gonna actually try to pull. This is a little more advanced, so you wanna push a lot with those arms. Don't let the arms buckle. keep your arms strengthened here through the shoulders, through the elbows, through the ribs. You're going to look up between the hands, belly button towards your spine, just see if you can jump. Woo! Right to sit, let go. Come into that ball. Let's hold here. 4 minutes. 7. Nice tall spine. If you can really lengthen that neck. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hug those legs strong, a little bit closer to you. Then bend your knees. Keep your knees together. Hug them really tight here and around your spine away. Stretch out your right leg. Right arm comes up. Twist your right elbow against your left knee. Gaze over your left shoulder. Very good. Stay here, or to take the twist deeper, cross the left leg over the right. Tuck the right heel in a little bit, okay? And then even feel free to wrap this. So lots of options here. If you guys want to take this into kind of like your bow and arrow stretch, I'm going to show you that here. So you're going to take right hand to your left foot or ankle. Left arm through, okay? Open it upside, and you're in that bow and arrow. You can flex and point. And then if you want to take it to a floating pose, kind of let this shin drop over, wrap your right ankle on top, push, and float. Okay, those are just options. Come back to straight legs. Let's take a big forward fold. We're going to try all those options on the other side, or those of you that want an easier option, you're just going to simply hold the twist. So let's kind of see what that looks like. So right knee comes up, left arm up. Left elbow against right knee. This is your option if you're just wanting to maintain the twist. You can stay here the whole time and just feel that stretch. A little more advanced, you can cross left ankle over, maybe twist with that left arm. I'm sorry, that's your right ankle over left, twist with your left arm. Or you can tuck that left leg in and maybe even wrap. So by wrapping, I'm having my left elbow outside of my right knee, pulling through that little hole there, and then right arm comes behind. Then, to do that bow and arrow, for you guys to see this from the back may be helpful. So I'm taking my left hand to my right foot. I'm opening up side here, flexing and pointing through that foot. And I can just hold my right arm side or hold it on the floor if I need support. Then to come into that balancing pose, I'm going to bend my right elbow, place my right hand down, and then cross my left ankle on top. Push with the hands, and you can float a little bit. Once you're done here, just extend those legs, reach up and over. Slide your hands back, point your toes, lift your heart. This may be enough, or float up to reverse plank if you wish. Breathe in. Exhale, guys, one more breath in. As we exhale, slowly come down, flex those feet, hands behind the back, cross the heart forward, draw the arms high. Stretch your shoulders and chest. Relax those arms. All right, let's scoot our hips forward and slowly come down to our back. Bring your feet wide, let your knees fall together. Let your right hand come over your left shoulder, left hand over your right, eyes are closed. Giving yourself a little hug here, bringing energy back to your body. So we've done a lot of movements, and some of you may have done some of those advanced poses, some of you may have kept with the more simple ones, and that's totally fine. That's where I want to bring us today, is to that acceptance of wherever we're at. If we're in a more advanced pose or a more simple pose, that's not really the point of the class, but more so that we're exploring what our bodies can do for us and how they can inform us of our feelings, emotions, thoughts, and just where we are energetically in our bodies. So just helping us to bring that awareness to ourselves and move from there. Deep breaths in and out, coming back to maybe that question of what it is that we want to either release today that we're holding on to, or that we want to express, and just feeling free to bring some acceptance there. Keep those intentions, breathing in, exhaling, and when you're ready, open the knees, feel your lower back press flat, feel your hands move down by your hips, and let's roll the hips high. Option one, just stay here. Option two, walk your shoulders under, clasp those ankles. Option three, hands tucked under the shoulders, press into wheel. If you're in wheel, feel free to add some rocking, maybe dip the hips. Feel free to walk the hands in a bit if you like. As far as you feel comfortable doing. feel free to raise one leg wherever you're at, even if you're just keeping the upper body down. I like to circle the ankles here. Other side. Feel free to circle that ankle, even if your head is still down and you're just raising the hips. Feel free to try raising one arm if you are in a bridge, but just be mindful here. Don't fall on your head. You want to be careful, and you can always try one leg opposite arm. And try that a few times. That's a more advanced challenge, but it's great for those of you that are looking for a more advanced challenge today. And then tuck that chin, roll down that spine slowly. And if you've been here already, that's okay too. Kind of adjust on your mat, hug your knees. Just rocking a little side to side. So we're going to take a plow or a shoulder stand just because we've done some back bending to open the chest, open the heart. Let's just keep our legs up for a minute though and stir those ankles. Again, if you're more new to yoga, this may be better for you today, just this legs up the wall position. So also feel free to just stay here, stir those ankles, keeping those ankles nice and open. If you want to press your elbows into the ground, pull up into a shoulder stand. Maybe even let those legs fall overhead into a plow. Taking a few breaths, maybe even softening the knees. Very good. Once you feel ready, mount your spine down. Cross right leg over left. Bend those knees and bring them over towards the left, arms to the right. Take a few breaths in and out. When you're ready, bring your legs over to the right. Feel that twist, breathe in. Exhale. Couple more breaths in and out. All right, guys, from here, go ahead. Let your feet come together, knees open, reclined butterfly, eyes closed. Or you can slide your legs straight out for Shavasana. If you'd like to take a bit more time in Shavasana, please feel free. You can stay here as long as you need. But just for this little video here, I'm gonna take you guys out if you're ready. So feel free to keep laying if you'd like to. Otherwise, reach those arms back overhead. Legs out in front of you, breathe in. And exhale, let those muscles drop back into the floor. We're gonna walk the feet and give the knees a hug. Maybe rock a little bit side to side. And then feel free to just rock yourself back up to seated. We're gonna take either a cross-legged or a lotus position. And just kind of take a few shoulder rolls again, how we began. Shoulder rolls forward, head tips side to side. Roll that head side to side. And take one more big stretch up and around. Other way. And as we come up, notice how you're feeling. I hope you guys feel more open in your body, open in your mind, and more loving and accepting towards yourself today in this moment. Let's inhale those palms together. Bring those palms in front of the heart. And namaste. Thank you guys again, and I hope you have a beautiful rest of your day, rest of your week, and hopefully I'll be able to make a few more videos at some point in time. So thank you guys. Have a great day.